Welcome to the Simple Sophisticate podcast, where intelligent living is paired with signature style. I'm your host, Shannon Ables. And whether you're listening on your commute, exercising, working in the garden, or sitting down with a hot cup of tea or a cafe au lait, thank you for tuning in. Let's get started. Welcome to the 99th episode of The Simple Sophisticate. Today we are going to talk about obstacles, but we're going to look at it in a more positive light. You may be wondering, how do we do that? Well, today's title of the episode is Why Not Celebrate the Obstacles? And that's what we're going to dive into. How can we celebrate it? How can we look at these frustrating moments as a sign that we may just be doing something right? We're going to get into all of that in just a moment. But this week's Petit Plaisir is one of my favorite meals to have. And I have it just about every single day. I'm going to take you through what is seemingly a very simple meal, but it is absolutely delicious. I've never shared my recipe before. I've talked about it a lot in the book and in my blog. And finally today, I'm going to share the recipe, especially since in the last few weeks, I have upped the flavor quotient. And I found a new trick and it just made my taste buds start to dance. And I could not wait to share with you because I think you're going to enjoy it as well. So stay tuned at the end of today's episode to get the recipe that I am talking about. But now let's get to today's topic at hand. Why not celebrate the obstacles? I want to begin with a very simple quote from Molière. The greater the obstacle, the more glory in overcoming it. Here's a list for you. A broken boiler, rejected for a new job offer, credit card debt, weight gain, a broken heart, a difficult colleague, a difficult boss, a loss of trust, locking the keys in the car in a remote destination in the winter, taking the wrong bus in a foreign city to the wrong destination. Each of these events, while many small and others mind-boggling, without the right resources can appear to be a permanent roadblock in the moment in which they are plopped down in front of us without warning. After all, nobody plans on being rejected. Nobody wants to have their dreams crumpled up and tossed aside. We don't want to lose hope. But sometimes our hopes can be dashed temporarily. In that moment, we are unprepared, and so our responses come forth without rationale or foresight. For example, where's the money going to come from? How am I going to meet new people? It will be impossible to find a new job that I love. Lose 10 pounds? Even 20? Are you kidding me? From the observation of others, as well as from my own firsthand experience, I have bore witness to the fact that struggle offers the opportunity for a fine polish to occur of the person that you have the potential to become. However, it is our choice to use the proper tools and ointment to reach a state of beauty, which is always possible. Because we can also choose the harsh, abrasive scouring pad and rub ourselves raw and ragged so much so that we no longer resemble the person we once were, and not in a good way. In other words, our attitude, our response will dictate whether we rise or remain wounded. And here's another analogy, just for fun. If we don't tend to our wounds properly, they can and will become infected and adversely affect our health. Today, recall for a moment the greatest obstacle you've overcome. At the moment it arrived, what were your initial thoughts? Angst? Doubt, maybe? Dismay? Dubious apprehension? Defeat? Or maybe fear? Whichever negative response you had, you now know you've since overcome that obstacle and landed on the other side. Each of the examples I mentioned at the top of the episode are a glimpse of just a few of the obstacles I have had to strategize and maneuver around and eventually did solve just in these past 3 years. All of us have obstacles. All of us can overcome them, even if in the obstacle's infancy, we aren't sure we ever will be able to. Recently, I was reading an article about the definition of success, and it was written by finance expert Susie Orman. I was curious to see how she was going to define this ubiquitous term as it seems there are many definitions out there for this term success in all sorts of articles and all different sites. Having read more than a few articles on the topic of success, I wasn't expecting to be surprised by her definition, but I was, pleasantly so. Here's what she had to say. So to answer the question at hand, my metric for that fleeting moment, and she's referring to this idea of success, is when I have totally blown past the goal I was trying to achieve. Success is when the results are far beyond my wildest dreams, for I did not even know how to dream that big. For me, the key component for something to be truly successful is that I had fun and loved every minute doing it. In thinking about the true definition of success, I have decided that when all that you have been defined by ceases to be, and you still know who you are and like what you know, then you have truthfully succeeded. There's Susie Orman sharing her definition of success. And while I know she isn't speaking directly about fears or obstacles, the element of unexpectedness is something we forget about when we're shoved up against a seemingly immovable brick wall. We think we can't budge it. But you see, and this goes back to what she says about success, if we're passionate about the journey we've chosen, if we're enamored with the topic, with the subject matter, the issue, whatever it is, the goal we're pursuing, if we can't imagine doing something else, we won't let any obstacle get in our way, no matter how deeply entrenched it may seem at that time. We will successfully overcome the obstacle when we gain a broader peripheral vision to learn of new ways to maneuver around it, when we recognize our timeline may have to be adjusted, and when we accept we may not be as ready as we thought. But this doesn't mean we won't be ready eventually. I can remember vividly the precise moment each of the obstacles I shared earlier came into my life uninvited, as well as the thoughts that were swirling in my head at that time. Ugh. And it is precisely because of these obstacles that I sought out new skills, discovered new alternatives that I had been previously too ill-informed to appreciate, and developed into a better version of myself. Albeit, I, as well as all of us, are still a work in progress. Thus, I know more obstacles will arrive because I need to be polished a little bit more. But now, at least, I know I can overcome them, whatever they may be, as well. I accepted, sometimes reluctantly, that some of these obstacles were due to my immaturity at the time, and that I had something more to learn, that I needed to improve. And as I reflect on these obstacles or these moments and that I eventually did overcome and surpass, it was as if the universe was asking, so do you want to grow up? It's your choice. Because this is the thing. Guess what? Each time an obstacle arrives, it is our choice to, after having a temporary moment of grieving, after all, that's completely okay. Just make sure it's for a limited amount of time. Then after you're done with that, take a deep breath, pull on your boots, and start doing the hard work that is needed. Here's a quote from E.A. Bucciarini. Well, if it can be thought, it can be done. A problem can be overcome. Yes, it would have been easier if I had keys to unlock my car. Yes, in 5 minutes, had I not locked my keys in the car, I could have been at a cozy après-ski lounge, sipping hot chocolate and resting my feet. But that is not the case. I did lock the keys in the car. I made that mistake. And now I have to figure a way out. Put yourself in any scenario, and there is always something in hindsight we could have done to avoid it or prevent it. But we can't live backwards. We can only apply the lesson moving forward. And perhaps, just perhaps, we're learning this lesson so that we can appreciate something far more grand down the road. And when we do finally apply successfully the lesson, we won't haphazardly let it go or let it be taken for granted, as Sarah Dessenden says so beautifully in this particular quote. She says, "It was so risky and so scary, and yet at the same time, so beautiful. Maybe the truth was, it shouldn't be easy to be amazing. Then everything would be. It's the things you fight for and struggle with before earning that have the greatest worth. When something's difficult to come by, you'll do that much more to make sure it's even harder, if not impossible, to lose. Something to think about, most definitely. Obstacles don't happen because we deserve them, because we've done something wrong. Let's toss that notion aside. Rather, they happen to give us an opportunity to improve, to show us that, believe it or not, we can handle it, whatever it is. And when we choose to do so, what we will discover, even though it may take some time, will be worth the effort we expend with interest. Today's episode is a little different. No list today, but this idea has been on my mind. Just to give some context, yesterday was my last day of skiing here on the mountain. I decided to take it one more time up. We had gotten about 12 inches of snow a couple days ago, up on the mountain, that is. And I decided to take the boys up and do one more loop around our favorite cross-country park, snow park, for the season. So wrapping up this fantastic snow season we've had here. And then today, I was on the river paddleboarding in the sunshine at about it had about 60 degrees in the morning, about 10 o'clock in the morning. And it was this beautiful transition. As I was paddleboarding on the river, I started to think, a year ago today, I did not have the job offer to come to Bend. I had been working for it, but I did not have it. I could not have told you that I would be where I am today. Now, granted, I've had to shift around some dreams with some other that are tied to some other things, and I'm working on those and rearranging plans because it's not going to go exactly as I'd hoped, but it's going to happen. And I'm still striving forward because, man, so far the ones that I have overcome have shown me that with tenacity, patience, a little rearranging, amazing things can happen sometimes that we don't even know are possible at the time. So keep dreaming, keep striving forward. Don't let those obstacles get you down. It's okay to grieve for a moment if things just don't go your way, but then get up, keep going. You will be amazed. You will be amazed at the future that is ahead of you. I hope you've enjoyed today's episode. It is a little bit shorter, but that means I also have a lot more to talk about in this week's Petit Plaisir. So let's get to that. I'll take a brief break and I'll see you on the other side with this week's Petit Plaisir. Welcome to this week's Petit Plaisir, and I am so excited to share this with you. So I'm a fan of the Food Network and Cooking Channel and all those lovely, and then I have tons of cookbooks I'm always perusing through, as I mentioned last week, with Susan Loomis's latest cookbook and memoir, In a French Kitchen. And I have been trying to figure out how to up the deliciousness in my morning breakfast. So this week, and I finally did it, and I'm so excited. When I took a bite after having incorporated the changes the first time, I was blown away by the flavor, and it was such a simple change. So this week's Petit Plaisir is buttery steel cut oats. Now, if you've read my book or you've been on the blog for the last couple of years, you know that my breakfast is pretty much the same thing every day. I have steel cut oats and I have one egg and then I have my hot lemon water. And that's all I have. But it really does sustain me for a very long time. And I'll get into all the benefits in a second. But it's delicious. It's delicious. And ever since I've made the change, I've been doing this, I think, for 4 or 5 years. Part of the reason I have the same breakfast is because in the morning, I don't want to have to think about the unnecessary things. And I want to make sure that I'm getting well fed and will be able to power through the morning without needing to be re-energized. And I also want something that's simple and I want something that's healthy. So it hits all those marks: healthy, simple, and it sustains me. It's delicious, like I said, as well. So I want to share with you what I have discovered. First of all, this will take about 15 to 20 minutes, but that doesn't mean you have to be sitting in the kitchen or standing in the kitchen making it the entire time. And I'll explain what I do as this is cooking in the morning. The first thing I want to talk to you guys about is the reason why maybe you want to consider eating steel oats instead of maybe regular rolled oats, which are oatmeal, or quick oats, which you just have to stick in the microwave for 2 minutes and voila, it's done. Or maybe you don't eat oats at all and you just want to try this out once or twice a week. That's great too. But let me talk to you first of all about the difference between steel cut oats and rolled oats or other instant oatmeal products. First of all, and most importantly, it's all about the processing. There is less processing done to steel cut oats. That's basically it. And because of that, the process not being as extensive, it takes longer to cook steel cut oats. But that is what makes the difference, and that is what makes the difference for your health as well. So what are the benefits of eating steel cut oats? Number one, for me and for you, if you're busy, you have a lot to get done in the morning, you stay full longer. Why? Steel cut oats have a low glycemic index, and they also have a very high fiber count. So if you have a food that's a carbohydrate that has a low glycemic index, it will help you maintain a low blood glucose level, and therefore it actually does help prevent diabetes as well. With regards to fiber, you get 7 grams of fiber per 1/4 cup serving, and that's exactly what my recipe is going to call for one serving in the morning. So you're getting 7 grams of fiber, and that is what keeps you full longer. So the first thing is it keeps you full longer. As I just mentioned, it also helps prevent diabetes because of the low glycemic index. And the third one is it reduces the risk of heart disease. Now, all these are backed up by studies, and I'll provide a link to that on today's show notes, but I just want to kind of briefly mention the benefits. With regards to the reduced risk of heart disease, because it's rich in dietary fiber, and within that fiber has 2 grams of insoluble fiber, which is 15% of your recommended daily allowance if you're eating about a 2,000 calorie diet. In a study done by the Nurses Health Study, which followed 70,000 women for 10 years, they noticed and were able to document that their risk of coronary disease was decreased as it inhibits the absorption of cholesterol and lower LDL, which is known as your bad cholesterol. So there's another benefit. It reduces the risk of heart disease. It also reduces blood pressure, and it has 10% of your daily allowance of iron and B vitamins if you eat 1/4 a cup. So ching, 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 a lot of benefits. And so I'm going to give you the recipe for one person. Now, if you want for two, simply double it. And if you want for four, simply quadruple it, so on and so forth. I've done all three of those, and it doesn't take away from the flavor. So it's very simple to do. But because many of us are just hurrying and eating by ourselves, and we're getting off the day, maybe we're even traveling, and we have, you know, these are the ingredients you can buy if you go stay in a vacation apartment. This is a simple breakfast to have to keep you going, so you can go on all those tours and walking excursions that you're going on. But again, just double it or quadruple it for a little bit more. So the ingredients, you simply want 1/4 cup of organic steel cut oats. And I usually use Bob's Red Mill organic steel cut, or I've also used McCann's Original Irish Steel Oats. There are a bunch out there, but just make sure it's not the quick cooking. You don't want the rolled oats. You want steel cut oats. That's the huge thing. And they're small little granules. And actually, we'll have a picture on today's show notes of them so you can see what they look like pre-cooking. Then you're also going to want to have 3/4 cup of boiling water in your tea kettle. It's the easiest thing to do, and it does speed up the process a little bit. Also, to add the flavor, you want 1/4 cup either whole milk, no non-fat, not even skim if you want flavor. And you can also swap it out if you really want a lot of flavor, which I do this more often than not, heavy cream. So either 1/4 cup of whole milk or 1/4 cup of heavy cream. You're also going to need 1 tablespoon of unsalted butter. Choose top quality. And again, we'll show you a picture of the unsalted butter I use. I use some French butter, but there are so many brands out there. And then gather up your toppings. There are so many things you can add. Whatever you like adding to oatmeal, add it to this and just add it at the very end. I prefer unsalted sliced almonds, some raisins, and honey for sweetener. The directions are so simple. I lay them out in detail on the show notes, the simplyluxuriouslife.com/podcast99. But let me walk you through them here just in case you're listening to this and you're making breakfast. Hopefully you're enjoying a hot cup of tea or a hot cup of coffee while you're doing this. So all you're going to want to do is get out a skillet And you're going to want to put 1 tablespoon of that butter I was talking about into the skillet. This is over medium heat. And then immediately just put in your 1/4 cup of steel oats. You're going to toast those steel oats. And this is the secret that I have not been doing until just a couple of weeks ago. I do not know why it took me so long to figure this part out, but this is what makes all the difference. It adds the flavor to those oats. Ah, and it only takes 2 minutes. It takes about 2 minutes. So I would actually recommend heating up your kettle at the exact same time you're putting that steel cut oats into your skillet, because it's going to take about the same amount of time to bring that water to boil as it is to toast those oats. So you're bringing your water to boil at the same time as you're toasting the oats. When the tea kettle is singing or boiling, measure 3/4 cup of hot water into a liquid measuring cup and pour directly over the oats. Okay. This is going to cause the oats and the water to boil almost immediately, if not immediately. As soon as they're boiling, you want to reduce the heat to simmer or low to medium. Add a pinch of salt, okay, just for a little bit of extra flavor. And then you're not going to cover it. You're not going to touch it. You're not going to stir it. You're not going to do anything. You just let it sit for about 7 to 10 minutes. Now, if you're making a batch for 2 to 4 people, you're probably going to let it sit for about 15 to 20, 25 minutes. Just watch it. You're going to see that water be absorbed by all those oats. But as I've been timing it this last week, just to kind of let you know how long it took me, if it's on low to medium heat, it took me between 7 to 10 minutes for a 1/4 cup of oats to have that water be absorbed to the consistency that I like. Now, if you want it a little stiffer, then you can have it go a little longer. All right. So you haven't touched it. You haven't done anything, but it's ready. After 7 to 10 minutes, it's ready. Pour in your heavy cream or whole milk. It's still on the heat. Totally still in the heat. Keep it there. And maybe you have a really rich cream. Well, then don't add a full 1/4 cup. Just add 1/8 cup. You want to add just enough to add that lovely flavor and make it that consistency that you love. And now it's still going to cook a little bit longer, 1 to 2 minutes over low heat. And this is okay to stir at this point. You want to stir this in at this point. And whatever the consistency is that you're striving for, once it gets there, take it off the heat, put it in your bowl, and top with your favorite fruit, nuts, or natural sugars. And that's it. That's absolutely it. You're going to see in my picture that I like mine pretty thick and pretty less runny, I guess you could say. I have a picture that I took yesterday and shared on Instagram. So you'll see that. But again, depends on what you like. It's still going to have the flavor as long as you've toasted those oats. That's the key. Now on the weekend, what I like to do, and you'll see this in yesterday's image as well, I not only have my egg, I also like to get a croissant as a something a little special once a week I give myself, especially if I've gone for a walk with the boys. Yesterday, we went for a lovely walk up on the trails, and it was just nice to come home, have a little treat, but also have that regular breakfast that I know is going to satiate me. It really does. I think you're going to be amazed by how satiated you are, and it's delicious. It's delicious, and you've hit some of your checkpoints for your daily diet with regards to all those benefits that I mentioned at the top of the recipe. So bon appétit. I hope you've enjoyed this week's Petit Plaisir, where each week ideas are shared to make the everyday all the more enjoyable. Tune in at the end of each Monday's podcast, where I'll recommend a book, a film, a recipe, or from time to time, introduce you to an expert who offers insight into how to live simply, luxuriously, anything that is a simple pleasure to satiate your sophisticated taste. For today's recipe, visit the show notes, thesimplyluxuriouslife.com/podcast99. Thank you for tuning in to the Simple Sophisticate podcast, where intelligent living is paired with signature style. For more ideas and inspiration throughout the week, stop by the blog, The Simply Luxurious Life, or pick up the book, Choosing the Simply Luxurious Life, A Modern Woman's Guide. To stay caught up on the most recent podcast, blog posts, and receive exclusive news as well as an extra dose of inspiration newsletter, which arrives in your inbox each Friday morning to enjoy with a hot cup of tea or your morning coffee, just in time to jumpstart the weekend. Until next Monday, I'm your host, Shannon Ables. Bon genie.